You maybe know that if you study in Germany or in Europe in general, your studies normally end with a bachelor or master's degree. But you can achieve that with going to a university or a university of applied science, university or Fachhochschule in German. But what's the difference? That's what we're going to explain in this video. Hallo und herzlich willkommen to My Road to Germany, the channel you should subscribe when you want to move, study, work and live here in Germany. My name is Sebastian and in this video I will speak about the difference between a Fachhochschule and a university, or University of Applied Science and university. Because there is a difference, not all the people know, especially when you are from abroad, you maybe don't know the difference between those kind of institutions. And I will help you to understand that topic a little bit better and, of course, also to find out which type of university is the best for you. And to help you to understand that topic better, I prepared a little structure for you. And the first thing we will look on is the history and the background, because this will help you to understand what are the differences nowadays, which is the second point of our video. And the third point and the last point is that we will find out together what's the best for you. So if you should better go to a University of Applied Science or a university, or if it doesn't really matter. So what's the background of those different university types? Yeah, the University of Applied Science, in German called Fachhochschule, they were really emerged in the 1970s when they really started to grow. And first, those institutions were just about to teach people how to do things, compared to the university, where you also made a lot of research. So on Fachhochschulen, there was literally no research. This changed a little bit with the Hochschulrahmengesetz, that was like a law, that also forced or enabled the University of Applied Science to do research, but practical or application-orientated research. And within that time, there was no bachelor and master's in Europe. There was, at least in Germany, the Diplom, and you always ended your studies on a university, but also on a University of Applied Science with a Diplom. But if you went to a University of Applied Science, you had your Diplom and then in brackets written Fachhochschule or FH, which is the short version of Fachhochschule. But why am I telling you all of this? Well, this was like a two-class education, because the universities were like really on the top, while the University of Applied Science were, let's say, a little bit below, in the past even more, and then it changed. And it changed until in the year 2000, there was the Bologna process. And within that, Europe, or within whole Europe, the states tried to make the certificates that you earn after you finish your studies, so their academic degrees, equal and comparable. So within that, they introduced the bachelor and the master system. So at least from that point on, those both diplomas were now really valued the same. So it didn't matter, starting from 2000 on, it was a longer process, so it didn't directly change everywhere, but it changed. So the University of Applied Science, if you're done there, then you receive your bachelor or your master's after, and it's exactly the same on the university. So those certificates, academic degrees, were valued the same and not as before, like the university was here and the Fachhochschule was a little bit below. So as we saw now, universities and universities of applied science are exactly the same. You receive the same certificate, the same academic degree. But this brings us to the second point. What's the difference then between those institutions? The first thing is the entry qualification that you need. If you want to study on a university, you need a so-called Allgemeine Hochschulreife here in Germany, which is the highest degree that you can receive when you're leaving school. University of Applied Science, you can also enter this with the degree that I just named, but there are also other ways. So you can also make an apprenticeship. If you don't know what that is, I can make another video about it. So you can go and study on a University of Applied Science even without an Abitur, or you can make your Abitur, so your A-levels, on different kind of ways. So in short words, there are more ways to get into University of Applied Science than to a university. So with that, you can say that you can find on a University of Applied Science also lower qualified people. But just if you look on that perspective from the school degree that they once received and not how they developed after. And it also doesn't mean that everyone that has the highest degree, so the Allgemeine Fachhochschulreife, is just going to university. For example, I also have the Allgemeine Hochschulreife, which is the highest school degree here in Germany. And even though I went to University of Applied Science, because it just fit better to me. So it's not that all those people just go there and the other one goes there. There are different kind of ways and you really have to check what fits for you, what we will discuss further at the end of the video. And when you are coming from abroad and you don't know how valuable your school degree is here in Germany, there is a site I can recommend you. It's called Anabin. I will also link it in the comments or in the description of the video. And you can check that out to get a first impression. Even, I guess, depends where you're coming from and to which school you've went to. You gotta check more details. You gotta get in contact with some institutions. That's a topic for another video, but if you're interested in that, please let me know. The second difference is the field of studies that you can choose on a university or a University of Applied Science. Because there are studies that you can just find in universities. As for example, if you want to study medicine, if you want to study law, if you want to be a teacher, then you need to go to university. And also those kind of things like maths, biology, chemistry, and those kind of studies, you normally go to university. On the other side, there are some field of studies that you are more likely to find on a University of Applied Science. So for example, business administration, you find more often on Fachhochschule, that is focusing more on their, let's say, closer perspective on business, while on the university, it's more likely to study their economics, which take more into account a broader perspective. So not like on the business itself, but also on the finance market and how politics can influence businesses and so on. You also have it here, but the focus here is a little bit different. So of course, in both institutions, you can study somehow something related with economics, but the focus is a little bit different. Third is the right for promotion or the PhD, because in Germany at the moment, you're only able to do your PhD on a university. You can also achieve this when you are on a University of Applied Science, but normally you need to work together with a university. But this doesn't mean that you can't achieve this. If you now, for example, studied on a University of Applied Science, you can still do, for example, your bachelor there, you can do your master on a university, and then you do your PhD there. And it's also often about that you need contact to people, that you need to know the professors, where you can do your PhD and with who. So if you already know that you want to go in the research area, if you want to do a PhD, then I can also recommend you to go to a university. Fourth point are the different professors or the different kind of professors. And the case is that in a University of Applied Science, if you want to be a professor there, you need 5 years of working experience and at least like 3 years of working experience in the free economy. While on a university, you don't need this. So this means on a university, you can do your bachelor, master, PhD there, then work 1 or 2 years on the university, and then, for example, start to teach economics. So it's a different approach. Normally, the professors of the university also have practical experience in the free economy. It's not that they don't have it, but by law, it's just mandatory for the University of Applied Science, while you can also meet professors, as I just explained, they just have their academic career, but no professional experience in the free economy. The fifth point, and that is maybe the result of all the points that I already named, is the practical versus the theoretical approach. Of course, you get an academic background in both institutions, and of course, you will learn about models, theories, how the things are going, that you are able to adapt those models and use them in your practical daily life at work. But still, as it was historically, there is a difference. So as we saw, for example, the rule with the PhD, that is also based on this, because still universities are focusing more on research, maybe a little bit more theoretically, what goes together with this, while the University of Applied Science are more practical orientated. And how does this show up? For example, in University of Applied Science, you have smaller groups in your bachelor. For example, I was with around 80 people in my bachelor's group. We were in total 400, but we were divided into 5 or 6 groups. While on a university, when you start to study economics, and I started business administration, the difference what I explained before, you are likely to start with 500-600 people to study there. The second thing is that most of the time you have an internship as necessarily or mandatorily included into your studies on a University of Applied Science, while you're not forced to do this on a university. So on a University of Applied Science, this is included in your studies, and if you are not doing this, you cannot get your degree. The next thing is, at least as it was in my studies, you also have within your studies a more practical approach. So we made projects with companies together, like real companies. For example, in the 6th and 7th semester, we choose our majors, and there we had projects where we have to make maybe a concept for a bank, or we have to help a regional institution to make their marketing strategy. Depends on the major that you choose, but so you already get in contact more with companies and you really work together with them, what from my perspective is definitely a plus. The next point, which also goes together somehow with that, is that in the university you are more free, so you can choose more of your courses, while in a University of Applied Science it's more like in the school, so that you have your fixed schedule. Sometimes you even need to attend because the professors really take care about it, while in the universities no one cares because our bigger group is more anonymous. Why in the University of Applied Science you sometimes have this? Of course, not always. For example, I never had it, but it's more likely to be. So with all this background and all those information, we come to the conclusion or my practical tips to choose what's the best for you. And I think you should ask yourself several questions. So for example, what do I want to do in the future? Do I want to work more in the research area? Do I maybe want to make a PhD? Then you should definitely try to get into a university and not into a University of Applied Science. The second is the field of studies that you are in, because some kind of studies you can just do, or you can just study on a university. So you don't even have to ask yourself this question. You just gotta go there. Then it's important to understand your kind of personality. So are you more someone that needs like a lot of freedom and that really likes to choose things, to do the things by his own? Or are you maybe more a little bit that you want to work together in groups, that you want to have smaller groups, that you want to have it a little bit more personal? Then I think Fachhochschule or University of Applied Science is the better way for you. I can tell you from my own perspective that I choose to study on a University of Applied Science because I think, especially in the economics field and area, you really need a practical approach because it's a descriptive science. So it doesn't help you, at least in my eyes, if you have more models and more theoretical thing. You really got to do things. You really got to figure out how it is in the free economy, how things are done. And that's why I think this is a big plus, this practical approach, this practical experience that you are forced to. Of course, you can also do an intern like in your summer holidays, for example, when you study on a university. So you can build yourself this practical approach. It's not that you can't, but at least from my perspective, this was the right choice for me. So really ask yourself, what do you want and which kind of person you are? And maybe the last point that is also interesting for you, if it really matters when it comes to salary or to find a job, there it doesn't really matter, because there are studies that show that people who went to University of Applied Science, they even earned more than people from a university, but later it changed a little bit. And it also depends on your studies, because, for example, philosophy, you can just study on a university. It's more likely to be paid not that well as technical studies that are often taught in university of applied science. So there's literally not really a difference. So from that perspective, you shouldn't care too much. So you should just check what is important for you. And it's not as before, as we saw in the past, that university of applied science is still worth less than a university. Some people still think so, but I don't think so. And if you look on the numbers, as I just said, with the salary and how easy or how quick you find a job, it's definitely not the case. So that was the video. I hope I was able to explain you well what's the difference between Fachhochschule and university. So if you like the video, I would be happy if you ring the bell and subscribe to the channel to not miss any video. Thanks for watching. Your Sebastian.